So here's my fucking moment. Pardon my tongue. So I produced this record for this group. This is even before the David Banner, the Crooked Ladder stuff. This is probably my first and biggest placement. I was producing a whole album for a group called The Elders. The label offered me a lot of money, okay? They offered me a lot more money than I had ever encountered up front. But they were like, if we give you this cream, we're gonna own the music. So we can put produced by, you know, Bobby Butterfingers, Bobby Butterbutt, and you won't get a dime. We're gonna cut you, it's gonna be a work for hire. We're gonna pay you for this money, I mean, pay you for these beats, and we're gonna do what we want with them. And at that time, I knew enough to know, like, nah, I don't wanna do that. Nah, just give me a little bit up front, a little advance, and then I'm rocking with this group. So I left the Bay, but I was still going back and forth, wrapping up the album with the group. And I called the label to check on some airlines, some flights, you know, the status of some flights, you know, so I can go back out there and finish the record, because I was living in Mississippi by this time. And they told me, well, there's no need to mix the album because we're shelving it, because someone in the group physically got into it in a meeting, in a board meeting, physically got into it with one of the owners of the label that happened to be there. And all I kept thinking is, God damn, I should have took that money. So that was like, fuck it, man. I just got to keep rolling. But man, I wish I would have had that cream. It was a lot of money, y'all. See, you never, it's a roll of the dice. This music shit is a roll of the dice.
When people say, you know, who are your top three? I never hear people say Large Professor, but they don't realize how much he's influenced the game, you know? And it's, you know, it's kind of his personality too, because he's just a humble, chill cat, but he definitely should get more love than he gets. I'll throw in Ali Shaheed Muhammad from Tribe Called Quest. I mean, he's done so much dope stuff within Tribe, outside the Tribe, that people don't know.
Yeah, the music is so much broader than any one aspect. You know, whether it's either of those, looking at, say, a piano or a drum machine or jazz or hip hop or house music, because I mean, I don't really care. Like, some people have an issue when it's like, yeah, man, you're not house enough, you're not jazz enough, you're not this enough. It's like, come on, it's just music.
When we first came in the game, it was that era and time when DJs actually spent the music that they like. Now, they're spinning music for whatever reason. I really don't know firsthand because I'm not involved with that. But you know, I mean, it's gotta be some reason why there's not a lot of good music on the radio.
What I want UBB to be remembered as that we were most definitely instrumental for keeping hip hop. Because I think that the backbone that hip hop was losing in the drum machine era of hip hop, we were able to facilitate when the sampling craze came in.